Currently, in the United States alone, over 40 million people have been diagnosed with an autoimmune disease. After experiencing side effects from medications for rheumatoid arthritis, I began a search for the underlying cause and soon learned others were on the same path and seeking answers where mainstream medicine had failed.
So the concept is when your immune system is activated, it's activated to protect you. Rarely is it an immune system that's gone haywire and doesn't have any controls. So the question is, what is it trying to protect you from?
I basically came to the conclusion I was a defective person. Like, I'm just not a full person, a whole person.
In addition to the autoimmune epidemic, over 300,000 people are diagnosed with Lyme disease each year, though many may be misdiagnosed, as the symptoms often mimic those in autoimmune diseases.
I would say, I have muscle pain, I don't have joint pain. And they would say, well, you have rheumatoid arthritis.
One of the great challenges of it is that it's considered it lives inside the cell. It's very difficult for the immune system to be able to attack it.
She called me and was like, I'm so sorry, but you came back positive for Lyme disease. Well, I was like, what are you sorry about? This is great. I'm gonna take antibiotics and I'm gonna get better. I had no idea what I was in for.
There's a lot of testing and treatments that are available, it's just people don't know about it. Everybody has the capability to heal themselves. Everybody has the capacity to be their best. And what is the, we'll say, right combination to figure out how to make that person perform at the best?
We're starting to realize, well, you know, maybe I'm the healing agent. You know, maybe it actually starts with me and it starts with my own consciousness and it starts with how I'm processing my emotions.
We're part of a giant pulsating energy field and we're trading information all the time with this field. And then you've got the whole idea that thoughts are an actual something with the capacity to change physical matter.
These are the stories of those of us proving that healing is possible and that we must redefine what we expect from ourselves and from our medical system.
My favorite one is the one who said to me, you're never gonna get better, you know? And I said, I don't really think that that's up to you.